The best 3D printers are all about precision, speed, and detail. But with so many options out there like Creality, Bambu, and Elegoo, it can be tough to figure out which one is right for you. To help you pick the right one, I've rounded up the top 6 3D printers and highlighted their key features. As the technology has advanced, 3D printers have become way more accessible and affordable, whether you're a hobbyist, a professional, or even a business. When you pair them with the right 3D modeling software, they offer an amazing creative space for designing products, prototyping, or just building cool stuff for fun. Plus, I'll go over a few things you should keep in mind when choosing the best one for your needs. So, let's get started. Number 6. FlashForge Adventurer 5M Pro. If you're considering diving into high-speed 3D printing, this might just be the machine for you. The Adventurer 5M Pro comes with a build volume of 220x220mm, which is pretty standard, but still plenty spacious for most projects. What really sets this printer apart is its Corexy motion system, which allows for lightning-fast print speeds of up to 600mm/s. Coupled with the direct drive extruder, it's designed to handle high-speed printing without missing a beat. One of the coolest features here is its fully unclosed build chamber, which helps to maintain a consistent temperature, super important for printing with materials that are sensitive to temperature fluctuations. Plus, it comes with a built-in air filtration system, keeping your workspace cleaner and safer. However, it's not all sunshine and rainbows. The FlashPrint 5 software is a bit of a letdown. It only provides one print profile per nozzle, which limits your options for optimizing print speed and quality. Additionally, the auto-leveling feature can be hit or miss, often requiring multiple attempts to get it right. The included webcam, with its 640 by 480 resolution, is another weak point. It's just not very useful for detailed monitoring. Despite these drawbacks, the Adventurer 5M Pro is priced at around $599, making it a solid choice for prosumers who don't mind a bit of software hassle for the sake of speed and efficiency. If you're okay with tinkering a bit to get the most out of this printer, it's high speed capabilities and professional features make it a compelling option. So, if you're ready to speed up your 3D printing game and don't mind a bit of software finagling, the FlashForge Adventurer 5M Pro could be just what you're looking for. Number 5. Qidi X Max 3, a large format 3D printer that might just be the game changer you've been looking for. If you've ever felt limited by the typical 250x250x250 build volume of most 3D printers, you're not alone. But the X Max 3 offers something different. A bigger build area without sacrificing quality. The fully enclosed build chamber is a huge plus for printing with high-temperature filaments and ensures safety by keeping curious fingers away from the hot components. It's a great feature for those of you working with materials like ABS or nylon. Speaking of size, the X Max 3 boasts an impressive build volume of 325x325x315. This extra space is perfect for those larger projects or intricate models that just won't fit on smaller printers. The nozzle is made from a copper alloy and hardened steel, making it durable enough to handle tough filaments. The heated build plate can reach up to 120 degrees Celsius, which is fantastic for minimizing warping on larger prints. However, not everything is perfect. One major downside is the lack of native power loss recovery. This is a feature we're seeing more and more in newer models, and its absence here can lead to frustrating failures, especially on long prints. Imagine losing power almost at the end of a large print, definitely a pain point. The X Max 3 does well with its fast printing speeds of up to 600mm/s, while still maintaining quality. But be aware, temperature fluctuations on the heated bed can cause issues like warping, particularly when printing multiple models simultaneously. Another thing to consider is the overall build quality. While the internal mechanics are solid, the exterior feels a bit cheap for around $899 machine. The filament spool holder is also placed at the back, which can be inconvenient if you're working in tight spaces. In conclusion, if you're in the market for a large format 3D printer and can live with a few quirks, the Qidi X Max 3 offers a lot of potential. Number 4. Elegoo Neptune 4 Pro, the best budget 3D printer in our list. The Neptune 4 Pro sports a powerful direct drive extruder, which ensures smooth filament flow and reliable extrusion. And check this out, its new Sport Mode part cooling fan is a game changer. This fan cools your prints almost instantly, which is fantastic. fantastic for materials like plaid. It helps prevent warping, especially on those tricky overhangs. Plus, the addition of linear rods enhances printing speed, giving you faster and more precise results. This feature is not common in printers under $300, making it a real highlight. The Neptune 4 Pro offers a build volume of 225x225x265mm and runs on a 310W power supply. The nozzle can reach up to 300 degrees Celsius, and the heated bed goes up to 110 degrees Celsius. You also get a 4.3-inch color touchscreen interface, which makes navigating the Clipper firmware a breeze. One of the coolest features is the metal rods on the X and Y axes, which provide smoother motion compared to traditional V-slot wheels. This not only enhances performance, but also gives the printer a more polished look. However, it's not all perfect. One downside is that the build platform leveling still requires manual adjustment. While this can be a bit tedious, it's manageable with a bit of patience and care. In summary, the Elegoo Neptune 4 Pro delivers exceptional speed and cooling capabilities for its price. While the manual leveling might be a bit of a drawback compared to fully automated systems, its overall performance and features make it a fantastic choice. Number 3. Original Prusa MK4, the latest and greatest from Prusa Research, and best quality choice in our list. So, what's new with the MK4? First off, it has a more robust aluminum frame compared to its predecessor, which means it's more stable at high speeds. This is crucial since the MK4 can print up to 600mm. Yes, you heard that right. That speed is thanks to the new Nextruder system. This direct drive extruder uses a dual gear setup to handle flexible materials like TPU with ease. You also get a swappable nozzle, which is great for switching between detail work and structural prints without hassle. The MK4 boasts a build volume of 210x250x220mm and supports a variety of materials, including plaw, patch, abs, and more. The all-metal Houghton can reach up to 290 degrees Celsius, and the heated bed goes up to 120 degrees Celsius. However, while the MK4 maintains the exceptional print quality we loved in the MK3, it doesn't introduce significant improvements in that area. It's fast and reliable, but the overall print quality is similar to the MK3. One downside is the setup for network connectivity. While it has Wi-Fi and Ethernet, both require additional software, making remote printing more complicated than it should be. An app or more straightforward integration would be a welcome improvement here. The MK4 is priced at around $1,149, which might feel steep compared to newer competitors. In conclusion, the Prusa MK4 is a solid upgrade, especially if speed and quality are your priorities. It's a fantastic machine for those who appreciate incremental improvements and are already invested in the Prusa ecosystem. However, for newcomers or those on a tighter budget, exploring other options might be worthwhile. Number 2. Creality K1 Max, one of the most exciting 3D printers that provides the most value, priced at around $900 on the market right now. Creality has been known for making affordable 3D printers, but with the K1 Max, they're aiming for the stars. This printer is part of their latest lineup, and it comes with some impressive upgrades. For starters, the K1 Max boasts a build volume of 300x300mm. That's a significant step up from the K1's 220x220x250mm, and it's perfect for those larger prints, like full-size cosplay helmets or big props. One of the coolest features of the K1 Max is its LiDAR-assisted bed leveling. This advanced system ensures a perfectly level bed, which is crucial for high-speed printing. Speaking of speed, K1 Max can handle speeds up to 600mm, though in practice, you'll get the best results at around 150 to 300mm. The Max's larger build area allows for even more impressive prints without compromising on quality. However, it's not all smooth sailing. I did encounter some issues with filament feeding on the K1 Max. The PTFE tube can be a bit finicky, causing occasional jams. While it's not a deal breaker, it's something to be aware of. A bit of adjustment usually fixes it, but it can be a minor hassle. K1 Max comes with a direct drive extruder, a ceramic Houghton that reaches up to 300 degrees Celsius, and a filament runout sensor. It also includes a time-lapse camera, which is great for keeping an eye on your prints. On the downside, the Creality app has received mixed reviews. While it's functional for monitoring prints and adjusting settings, its model library and slicer features have raised some concerns about intellectual property. So, should you buy the K1 Max? If you have around $900, I'd say it's a fantastic choice. Number 1. Bambu Lab X1 Carbon. Best overall printer that's been turning heads in the prosumer space, priced at around 1,400 $499. And trust me, it's not just talk, this machine really does live up to the buzz. The X1 Carbon features a build volume of 256 cubic millimeters, which is quite spacious for most projects. It's got a rigid steel frame with an aluminum shell and runs on a Corex motion system, allowing it to achieve print speeds of up to 500 mm. That's some serious speed. Plus, it can handle a wide range of materials from PLA to ABS and even ASA. One of its standout features is the LiDAR-assisted bed leveling and automatic flow calibration. This system ensures you get a perfect first layer every time, which is crucial for avoiding print failures. The printer also includes a magnetic flexible removable platform, although the textured PI plate is optional and not included by default. Now, on to the cool stuff, the AMS or automated material system. This is a game changer. It can hold up to 4 spools of filament, allowing you to print in multiple colors without the hassle of manual changes. This is perfect for complex, multicolor prints. However, the purging process does waste a bit of filament, which could be a concern if you're watching your material costs. One downside to note is that nozzle replacement is a bit of a chore. You have to replace the entire hotend, which can be fiddly. Also, the lack of a PI textured plate included in the box feels like an oversight. A textured PI surface is great for adhesion and would add a lot of value. Overall, if you're serious about 3D printing and ready to invest in a top-notch machine, the Bambu Lab X1 Carbon is a fantastic choice. That's all for today, guys. If you enjoyed the video, give us a thumbs up and don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more tech reviews. And make sure to click the notification bell so you're always updated with the latest reviews. Oh, we're eager to hear from you. Let us know what you'd like us to cover next. Your feedback helps us create content tailored to your interests and keeps us delivering the tech insights you're looking for. See you in the next video.